This is a public service announcement being brought to you by the College Foundation of West Virginia. Caring for your mental and emotional health is an important part of preparing for college. Whether you are moving away from home for the first time, going back to school, or enrolling part-time while living at home and balancing work and family responsibilities, it's normal to experience emotional ups and downs during times of transition and uncertainty. During these times, having a plan for what to do when you feel down can help. This may include making a playlist of songs that help you feel calm, saving numbers for support hotlines in your phone, making plans with a friend to check in, or researching and practicing mindfulness techniques. Feeling stress is a normal reaction to situations we face, both good and bad, but unchecked stress can affect physical and mental health. How you cope with and manage stress can make a positive impact on your mental health, relationships, and educational success. So what tools can help you manage the stress you'll experience in college? Research shows that sleep impacts physical and emotional health, so sticking to a regular sleep schedule is crucial. Research also shows that movement and exercise can help your mood. It's hard to make good decisions when you feel overwhelmed, so take some time to look up tips for making a list to help you prioritize and organize your thoughts and the things you need to complete. Remember to schedule time for sharing a meal or just hanging out with friends or family members who help you feel a sense of grounding. When you're stressed in the moment, it might sound simple, but breathe. Taking slow, deep breaths is a scientific way to calm down. Look up a couple breathing exercises, like the 4-7-8 technique, and practice. How do you know if feelings of sadness or stress are more than the normal ups and downs of preparing for or adjusting to college life? If these feelings last more than a couple weeks, are affecting your eating, ability to concentrate, or you're having drastic mood changes, it's time to reach out and talk with someone you trust about what's going on. Sharing how you feel is a sign of courage. That person might be a friend, coach, instructor, or family member. Their help may include providing a listening ear and encouraging or assisting you in making an appointment with a doctor, counselor, or other professional. If you aren't sure who to talk with, or if you or someone you know is thinking about suicide, text START to 741-741 to reach a crisis counselor at the Crisis Text Line, or call the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 800-273-8255.